Hello everybody and welcome to what is going to be my third blog. We're up here in Joburg. It was a fantastic week for myself. Was really, really delighted to score my maiden test 100, especially after the heartache of scoring 95 at Lord's against the same opponents, especially when Morne Morkel came back out and started the ball, and I was thinking, please don't get out now, I can't go through that again. So to get over the line and to make a contribution like that in what is a fantastic venue and somewhere that with such historic prowess is something that will definitely stay in my memory for a long time. People have commented a bit on my celebrations and things like that. Obviously nearly falling over backwards, that was all passion and pride really. It was a lot of emotion going straight through my veins. It was just something that takes over you, something that you've waited all your life to do. It was one of those moments that I don't think I'll ever forget. It was, I mean, just thinking about it now, I've got a massive beaming smile, and you kind of forget everything that you're doing. Obviously Stokes, he runs and keeps running. I just kind of threw myself backwards. Everyone's celebrations are different, and obviously dealing with that and then getting refocused for the next ball can be quite challenging, especially when everyone's still going, your adrenaline's still going. But for me, it's just a case of, right, I had to take a step back, a couple of deep breaths, get my helmet on, recompose yourself. For me, I take my guard again. After waiting so long, that experience of scoring 100, I want it to come sooner and sooner again. So I had my mum and sister over. There were some old family friends of mum's that were around as well. And to see them, that obviously knew Dad, have known me since I was a wee nipper playing in charity games down at Maidenhead and Bray, and Michael Parkinson's cricket matches, taking over from Dad, and the elation that they had for me, seeing them afterwards in the hotel was absolutely fantastic. It was really something that touched me deep. As many of you will have seen, I went out back into the middle to get stumps after the game was over, and I got one for myself and one for Ben. So hopefully we'll get the lads to sign those as a bit of memorabilia moving forward in years to come. Hey guys, just catching up from the hotel here in Johannesburg. I thought I'd just take this opportunity to try and take you through some of the things that we did in Cape Town. The time off that we had is so key. Obviously with back-to-back test matches we played, I think it was 10 days cricket in 12 days, so there was a lot of tired bodies around, people needing to refresh from what was a pretty grueling two test matches. So in those days off, obviously it's important to have a bit of downtime. We had our families out here, which was fantastic, just to get away from everything that was really cricket orientated, to be able to go down to the beach, to be able to see the sights of Cape Town, whether that be go up to Table Mountain, go up the Lion's Head, go to Camps Bay, just see different parts of Cape Town. I was lucky enough to have my sister and my mum here, which was great, and it was actually my mum's birthday, so we were very fortunate to go to a few very nice restaurants, take mum out, see the different sites, and then on the final day we went to Le Morand's Queen's Play at Kenilworth, which is the horse racing. It was a great spectacle. We were treated to a fantastic day out. So many thanks to everybody there that looked after us. James Taylor was part of the Bairstow clan during the day, which was interesting, shall we say. It was great to have him. It was great to have him round. With James Taylor's background in racing, obviously his dad used to be a jockey. He liked to think that he knew quite a bit about the racing, but I think that I just nipped him on the day and got a couple more winners. I met Eddie Jordan. Obviously he's friends with Morgie over in Ireland. Titch was fortunate enough to meet Bakkies Botha, the South African Rugby Union second row legend, and I'm sure you'll see from the pictures he is massive. So it was an interesting day all round, and a very fun one, enjoyed by all.